everybody. I'm home.
Oh.
Hello, Uncle Mort.
Well, Margie, I didn't know you were entertaining again.
Oh, this is Reed Hendricks.
How do you do?
Glad to know you, Reed. You're a new one.
Oh, I suppose I am.
You sit down, my boy. Now, what do you do?
He's on the crew.
Oh? What crew?
At college.
Well, she means I row.
Oh, that. Well, that's all good stuff. But if you take my advice, you won't let it interfere with your studies.
I'm sure he won't, Uncle Mort.
Good. Because when you get out of college, you won't find many jobs rowing a boat.
I think Leroy's looking for you.
He knows where to find me. What are your major interests besides rowing? And my niece Marjorie.
He said it was urgent.
I haven't gotten to know Reed yet.
Oh, we'll be seeing a lot of each other, undoubtedly.
I don't think you should keep Leroy waiting.
Well, we'll have a talk soon, my boy.
Pleasure meeting you, Mr. Gildersleeve.
Leroy! Leroy! Leroy?
Hi, Unc.
What did you want to see me about?
No, I don't want to see you.
Why, she said you did.
But she just wanted to get rid of you.
Oh?
She chased me out, too.
Well, she might not want her inquisitive little brother around, but why should she want to get rid of me?
You don't know?
Good evening, Mr. Gildersleeve.
Hello, Bertie.
Leroy, I've got to straighten up this place for dinner. Oh, did you see Marge's new boyfriend?
You know, I've just been talking to him, Bertie.
Don't you think he's nice?
Well, I don't know anything about him yet.
Marge says he might stay for dinner.
Oh?
He's a mighty hungry-looking guy. You think we have enough?
Leroy. I think I'll go in and ask him if he's related to any of the Hendricks I know.
Why don't you wait and ask him that at dinner?
There may be other things I want to ask him at dinner, Bertie.
If I stay for dinner, can we go to a show later?
Sure, we have a lot to talk about.
Oh, Reed. You know, don't get up. I was wondering if you were related to ex-Senator Ward Hendricks. Fine man.
No, I'm afraid not.
Oh. Just what does your family do?
Well...
Your father, I mean.
Unky.
Dinner isn't ready yet? What did you say he does?
He really doesn't do anything.
He doesn't?
Unky, is this so important?
I'm only interested in your young man's parents, his background.
Dad clips coupons.
He clips coupons? Well, that's good. Did he inherit his wealth or earn it?
Well...
There was a Hendricks upstate that married money.
Would you like to go for a walk before dinner?
I don't think I can stay for dinner after all.
Oh, why not?
I really should drive upstate to see my parents.
Oh, that's nice.
Would you like to walk out to the car with me?
I think it's a good idea.
Be sure to give your parents my regards.
Yeah.
Next time I get a boyfriend, I won't bring him in.
What did I do?
Bertie?
Yes, dear?
Did you do this for me?
Yes, indeed. My, don't you look beautiful.
Thank you.
Who's the lucky young man tonight?
Gregory.
Gregory? You haven't had him around.
Not after what happened last week with Reed Hendricks. Oh, there he is. I want to get away before Uncle Mort comes down.
Oh.
Bye.
Bye, honey. Have a good time.
Thank you.
And that's my complete version of art.
Oh, it's been a wonderful evening, Gregory.
For me too, Marge. The nicest I've had since I started working here.
I wish I could believe that, you with those models around your studio.
Painting is how I make a living, Marge, not how I make dates.
I still wish I could believe it.
You can.
Yes?
I've been looking at that locket all evening.
Yes?
You carry pictures in it?
Well, yes.
Men's?
Well.
Competition?
Sort of.
Let me see.
No.
Please.
Oh, all right.
You picked them at strange ages.
Well, that's my uncle and my brother, silly.
Oh.
Oh, and speaking of my uncle, I'd better be getting in.
Oh?
He's a difficult man.
Well, I'd like to meet him.
Oh, not tonight. Oh, really, I do want you to meet him sometime, but after he's gotten used to the idea that we go out together. He doesn't mean to, but he has a way of butting in and doing strange things.
Well, let's not worry about him now.
Oh, but right now I can see him upstairs with his eyes wide open, steaming about where I am.
Who?
<Ooh. laughs>
time for your sister to come upstairs.
Gosh, isn't Marge home yet?
No, she's sitting out there in a car.
Smooching, huh?
Well, I'm going to tell her to come in.
Right in the middle of a smooch?
Marge!
Wonder who a date is.
I don't know, but where's Marge?
She's with him. They're walking so close together, it looks like one person.
Hey, now.
Good night, Marjorie.
Good night, Gregory, darling.
Whoop, wait till she closes that door.
You've got a long wait, Unc.
You would.
Well, as long as I'm up, I might as well see the show.
Good night, Gregory.
Good night.
This is where I came in.
This is where Marjorie better come in. Leroy, you go back to bed.
Okay, Uncle.
Marjorie? Hi,
Unky.
Marjorie, I want to talk to you.
Good night, Unky.
Marjorie, I want to talk to you.
Don't spoil the mood, Uncle Moore. I have a date with a dream.
Mr. Gildersleeve, doesn't your breakfast suit you?
It's all right, Bertie. I've decided to wait until Leroy brings Marjorie down.
Something wrong?
Everything's fine. Dandy.
Yes, sir, but your breakfast is getting cold. Wouldn't you like me to heat it up for you?
No, thank you, Bertie.
I put it there and it's getting cold. No need to cook it if you're just going to leave it late.
Now, Bertie.
I put it there. That's all I can do. Getting cold.
She said she'd be down in a minute, Unc.
Thank you, my boy.
She's working on the bags under her eyes.
I don't doubt it.
Aren't you going to eat that?
We'll all eat together, Leroy.
But why shouldn't I go?
This is no time to start an argument with me. I just dare anybody to try it. Marjorie!
Good morning. Why do I have to get up?
Marjorie, do you realize you've kept us waiting for breakfast?
It's my morning to sleep, after all.
You should sleep at night. Now, I want to discuss your new boyfriend with you.
What's there to discuss? We're in love.
In love?
I could tell that from the upstairs window.
Good night, Gregory. Darling.
How can you be in love when I haven't even met him?
Uncle Mort, really?
Now, let's not pass this off lightly. What were you doing until 2 o'clock in the morning?
You must know we were talking about art.
Leroy, eat your breakfast.
Where is it?
Bertie!
Come in, Leroy!
You were talking about art until 2 o'clock in the morning?
Gregory's a painter.
A painter? Oh, my goodness.
What's he paint? Houses?
He's an artist. He's wonderful with a canvas.
You mean he paints real live models?
Of course. He has the cutest little studio in the loft of the arcade building.
Marjorie!
Oh, Uncle, he wants to paint me sometime.
Marjorie, I want you to break this up.
I will not.
Marjorie! Now, young lady, you listen to me. You hardly know the fellow. You haven't even brought him to the house for me to look over.
And you know why? Every time I look at somebody new, you object.
No, Marjorie.
When Freddie Gibbs came over here in his new car, you gave him such a lecture about being careful with your precious niece, he was afraid to drive.
Is that why you two sat out in the car all night?
And you know you discouraged Reed Hendricks because you wanted to climb his family tree to see if you couldn't find a missing link.
But Marjorie...
I'm sick of it, Uncle Mort. It makes a fool of me. I'm not going to stand for it anymore.
Well, this is different. What do we know about an artist?
Oh, there you go again. You're suspicious and unreasonable.
Me?
I'm not going to be treated like a little girl. I'm a woman.
I forbid you to become a woman. Yeah, I mean, to see that man again.
I will see him again. You can't stop me.
As long as you're my niece.
Marjorie. What's the matter? Something wrong with it?
No, Peavy, I'm too upset to eat any breakfast this morning.
Well, that's unusual for you, Mr. Gildersleeve.
Well, I'm not going to stand by and see Marjorie do something she'll regret.
Huh? Well, I've always considered Marjorie a very level-headed girl.
Yeah, but now all of a sudden she's talking about posing for Gregory somebody.
Phoebe?
I just don't understand women.
Well, about only half the people can. And they're all women.
By George, I've got a notion to barge up to that studio and see what's going on.
Oh, I don't think Margie'd like that.
Well, she doesn't have to know about it.
Oh, well, Gregory will know.
Well, he doesn't have to know I'm me.
The water commissioner's a pretty well-known figure around town.
I'll just go up there and won't give my right name. And then if I find anything out of line, I'll really let him know who I am in a hurry. I'll forbid him to see Marjorie.
Well, why do you think you'll find something out of line?
Well, he uses live girl models up there.
You don't say. I'll get my hat and go with you.
Kent'll be with you in a moment. He's in his apartment telephone.
Yeah, thank you. Does Mr. Kent spend most of his time painting girls?
Well, after all, he's an artist.
Oh, yeah, that's right.
You wanted to see me?
No. Oh. Are you Mr. Kent?
Yeah.
Gregory Kent?
That's right.
Well, I'm John T. Smith.
Oh, Mr. Smith?
That's right, Smith.
Oh, what can I do for you?
Well, I just came up to have a look around. Yeah, I mean, see if you have any paintings for sale and all.
Why, yes, every canvas you see is available.
Oh. Oops. Yeah.
Oh, Miss Carroll, we won't begin work until Mr. What did you say your name was?
Smith.
Miss Carroll, Mr. Smith.
How do you do?
Glad to meet you. Face to face.
I might say the same. And now, Mr. Smith, you're interested in still life?
Not especially.
Well, if you're thinking of something for the home, for your family, why not a portrait of yourself?
Portrait of me?
Well, you're a very distinguished-looking person, Mr. Smith.
You really think so?
Oh, very distinguished.
Well.
Sit up here a moment.
Up here?
Yes. I want to catch that strong chin in this light.
Oh, you mean like this?
Oh. You have a favorite medium? Pastels? Oils? Watercolors?
Well, water sounds good to me.
Good. Miss Carroll, would you please help pose Mr. Smith?
Of course.
Thank you. I'm new at this.
Fine, perfect. Can you come back tomorrow and sit?
Tomorrow? I suppose I would have to spend a good deal of time around here, wouldn't I?
Yes, we'll need several sittings.
By the way, what's this going to cost me?
$100. Mr. Smith, you lost your pose.
I did, didn't I?
Uncle doing home this time of day?
I don't know. He's been in his room for an hour.
He's mighty fly about something.
Hey, Uncle, when are you coming down?
Leroy, I have an important appointment. You go out and play.
Okay.
Leroy, I thought you went outside to play.
I'm playing inside. Are you addressing Parliament today?
I don't have time to answer silly questions.
Okay. Dedicating a new fireplace?
Leroy, I'm trying to get out without being seen.
Oh, there you are, Mr. Gildersleeve.
Yes, here I am.
That Asian wizard.
I got it. You're going to be a ringmaster.
Oh.
You're running away from home to join the circus because you had a battle with Marge.
Mr. Gildersleeve thinks lions would be easier to tame.
Please, Bertie, I don't want Marjorie to know about.
Hey, you're fighting a duel with her boyfriend? Paintbrushes are 20 paces.
Leroy!
Yeah, Marge?
Quick, help me.
What are you two trying to hide? Uncle Mark, what are you up to now?
Well.
Can't you see? He's a mummy.
Where are you going in that outfit?
No use asking. He's the mummiest mummy you ever saw.
It was very smart of you to pose in your cutaway, Mr. Smith.
Well, I thought as long as you're charging me $100, I might as well get a little gussied up.
Naturally. After all, this portrait may be in your family for generations. Could become an heirloom. Come in.
Hello, are we early?
I have a few more minutes with Mr. Smith. Just make yourselves at home, girls. Mr. Smith. Mr. Smith.
Who? Oh, me. When am I going to get to see what I look like in watercolors?
I'm afraid you'll have to wait till I finish.
When will that be?
Well, I think I can have it for you by the end of the week. Mr. Smith.
Oh, sorry. Love tennis.
You'll have to cooperate if you want your portrait by the end of the week. I can only give you a few more minutes today.
Oh, we'll make them count.
Then I have to make a few sketches of the girls. Then I have a date.
Oh?
Yes, a very special girl.
Your date? I'm just assuming. She's not a model.
Oh, no, but she could be, though. If she did model, I'm afraid her uncle would blow his top.
Her uncle?
She lives with him. He's a strange old duffer.
What makes you say that?
Well, it's the way she talks about him. Like he was a meddler. I think if he knew, he'd put a detective on me just to see if I was all right.
No, he wouldn't.
The other night when I took her home, I had the feeling he was peeking out of the window. Mr. Smith, your mouth is open. I can't understand how a girl as sweet as she is has such a weird character for an uncle. Well, that's all for today. You're beginning to squirm up there.
Well, pretty hot spot.
You're phoning from the corner? Well, Uncle Mort's just leaving. Why don't you wait about 5 minutes, then come over? Well, I have to hang up now. Here comes the Iron Duke. Goodbye, darling.
Go right ahead, my dear. Don't hang up on my account. Why don't you call him back? Enjoy yourself.
Are you feeling all right, Uncle Mort?
Oh, I'm feeling fine. Never better. And I must say, you've never looked prettier, my dear. I don't blame Gregory for falling for you.
What's come over you?
Marjorie, I'm sorry about the other morning. You were right. I was suspicious and unreasonable.
You certainly were.
I owe you an apology. Gregory's a fine boy. Splendid type, no doubt.
How do you know?
He must be. Or you wouldn't go out with him.
I was nasty too, Anki. You're wonderful.
Then everything's all right between us?
Of course. You know, it's funny. For a moment, I thought you'd been snooping around Gregory's studio to check up.
Really? Well, you've got to get downtown.
If you'd have done that, Uncle Mort, it would have been the end, the absolute end.
See?
Marge, you got a caller in the kitchen.
Was he here already?
Hi, Marge.
Hi, you didn't wait 5 minutes.
Oh, it seemed more like an hour.
Oh, Rick, let's sit down.
Who's he?
That's Brick, Marjorie's newest and biggest flame.
Oh, brother.
Well, hello, Mr. Smith.
Hello, Gregory.
What's the matter? Don't you feel well?
Not too. Oh, about my picture. If you haven't finished it yet, perhaps I can pay you for your time and just forget the whole thing.
But your portrait is ready.
It is?
Now, before I let you see it, I must have the light just right. Now, you stand right there. Just like that.
No, I'm sorry you went to all the trouble of finishing it, because I...
Of course, if you don't like it.
It's beautiful.
I knew you'd win it in at least a $50 frame.
Beautiful.
Just think how magnificent it'll look hanging in your home.
Oh, my goodness. I can't take it home. But it's beautiful.
Oh, hello, Commissioner.
Hello, Foggy.
I came in to clean your office, but it didn't need it. You haven't been here for 2 days.
Well, I've been busy.
Who is it?
Me.
Yeah? Who painted this lie?
Marjorie's boyfriend.
What do you have to pay for a facelifting job like that?
All right, boy.
Well, you aren't going to hang it over here next to the mayor.
No, guess not. Too pretty.
It's bigger than his. You'd be looking for a new job. Why don't you hang yourself at home?
Foley, if I take this home, I will hang myself. Beebe.
Oh, hello there, Mr. Gildersleeve.
Could you use a nice, expensive watercolor?
Hmm? Well, who is it?
Well, it's me.
You don't say.
Beautiful, isn't it?
Yes, it is.
The only trouble is I can't take it home. Marjorie'd know I was checking up on her boyfriend.
Oh, the chances are you worry too much about Marjorie's romances. Well, too bad you can't hang it over your mantle. Be quite a conversation piece.
Say, maybe I could take it home and still get credit for doing a nice thing.
How's that?
Well, I could tell Marjorie that I was helping her boyfriend get a start.
What about the Mr. Smith?
Well, I can say I was so modest that I wanted to remain anonymous.
You're quite a fellow, Mr. Gildersleeve. You're starting this game again.
Well, now, I wouldn't say that.
Hello, baby.
Hello there. Cup of coffee, please.
All right.
Well. Before and after? I'll take it.
Surprise for you.
Surprise?
What do you think of it?
Well, who is it?
It's me.
Oh, I want you to meet Brick.
Brick?
Yeah, what happened to Gregory?
Yeah, but I just paid.
How do you do?
How do you do?
Gee, that's really something. You know, Mr. Gildersleeve, that. Look.
Thank you.